Hi everyone, it's Andy from Hobby Headquarters. Well, as you know, there has been quite a few 16 scale model kits come out lately, and I've been wanting to create some dioramas to show these off. So I have a brand new wire foam cutter, a tabletop one, and lots of this pinkish purple insulation foam. And we're gonna cut some of this up and start making some dioramas. So the first one we're gonna make on this video is going to be for the European theater. So everything on the right side of the table here. And we're gonna make some cobblestone streets, but we're gonna take all the time and cut all of the individual cobblestones, plus all of the block for the wall, and just make a nice little scene that we can display some of our 16th scale vehicles, just like this here. So very excited to share this with you. So let's get started. Let's start off by cutting some foam. So I am making the cobblestones right here, and I'm using my 1-inch pink purple foam you get at the hardware store, and setting the wire at about a half an inch. I'm going down the line and cutting long strips of foam. Then I double stack those up and cut them directly in half to get our perfect square cobbles. And then it's just a matter of going down the line and cutting lots and lots and lots of these. In fact, by the time this is done, I think there's a little over 1,300 cobblestones in this diorama. And you'll see as we get further into the video that it's definitely worth all of the time and effort to put in here. You do occasionally want to make a couple different sizes. Now, this is the best part. You take all of the stones, separate them up, put them in a bucket, and I actually saw this on another YouTube channel called Black Magic Craft. Take a bunch of jagged rocks, actually quite a bit even more than that, seal up the container, and then shake the heck out of the container, and you get some very nicely rounded stones. And once you pull the foam pieces out of the bucket, you can see here it's rounded over all of the corners and created a nice texture on all of the cobblestones. And this is going to be the exact same technique we use later on to make our bigger stones. And you can see the texture on it a little bit better. And once you paint them, man, they look very, very nice. And now that we have all of these stones, we need to glue them onto our base. So I've temporarily set up these pieces of foam. These are going to be the sidewalk, and I've just put them into place. But what I want to do now is take our square and draw a line across here, and that way we have a nice starting point for all of the cobblestones to be nice and straight against the sidewalk. So now I can go ahead and remove all the sidewalk pieces. They're just sitting here, and we can start to lay the cobblestone. Now we're going to lay them down. I'm just going to use static tacked. I like this because it's a little bit thicker than some of the other glues. And I'm just going to lay an area down to begin with. Like that. And then just taking, in this case, okay, now that I have a nice even coat, just gonna take the cobblestones and as easy as this, just start laying them down. And all of them are not exactly the most perfect size, so you're gonna get little variations in it. And the variations I'm gonna leave off to one side so we can kind of make like a little area that has some that are higher than others, a little area that sunk down a little bit. But you can even see they're just slightly off from each other. And if I find one like this that is a lot shorter, we're gonna put that to the side and move on to the next one. And then once you've laid that course down, go ahead and apply another layer of glue, and we just keep on working on it. Okay, I've ran out of my first batch of cobblestones, and I have to say, though, I really think it's worth the extra work. And honestly, it didn't take that long. It took a couple of hours to cut and lay all these down. Before I start working on the next one, what I thought I would do is lay out my sidewalk to see how much more I'm going to need. And I've started making sidewalk pieces basically the same way we're doing the other bricks. I've taken these cubes, we've taken a rock, rough rock, and kind of just pushed in on the edges. I've cut the little border for the curb, and then also just put a few little cracks inside every other one. And now I'm going to go ahead and glue that into place all the way down the rind here, and then back to cutting more cobblestone. And also too, taking that rock that way I was just talking about, if there are any cobbles that are sticking up a little bit too high, you can always just push down with the rock. Not only does it create more texture, it'll put the rock or the cobblestone a little bit more in line if you've got one that's just a little bit too high for you. But man, the unevenness and the look of it, even with the pink foam, it looks pretty cool, just even with the pink foam. But once we paint it and put a little dirt and grime and stuff on it, I think it's going to look great. So I'm going to go ahead and get that sidewalk glued in right now. Okay, I have all of these beautiful cobblestones laid down, and there's over 1,000 of them that I've put down. But I really think it adds a lot of realism, especially in the 16 scale. And as you can see here too, I've gone ahead and put the sidewalk completely in. Now what I need to do is completely seal this in. And I'm using a mixture of Mod Podge with a little water and some black paint to get kind of a gray color. And we're just going to go ahead and just start rubbing this all in. And while that gray Mod Podge dries on top of all of our work, I've gone ahead and started to create the wall block. And I've made these larger blocks, and I've made two sizes. One for the alternating piece, so when we stack them like this, it'll make sense. We can make square type of walls altogether. And I'm putting them inside here. We're shaking them up once again with all of the rocks. And you see after just like about 45 seconds, you start to get all of the little dents and stuff like on it, like a real block. And I think what I might do on this is actually shake these up a little bit more and really distress them a lot more before we start gluing them together. Okay, the first couple of layers have dried, and now we're just going to continue to build this up. At this current point right now, adding this next layer, it puts this at a, in 16 scale, a 5-foot wall. So I want to go for like a 6-foot garden wall, so we're going to have to do just a couple more layers on top of this. That way it's a type of wall that the average person just couldn't look over the top of. So we've got at least one more layer after this. Here is the completed garden wall. Gone ahead and mitered the edges on both sides so it'll fit right into the little area that we've created. But before we attach it, I want to go ahead and I want to put some grout in, or mortar in between all of the blocks right there. So we want just a thin little line, and I'm going to use the MIG acrylic concrete. And this goes on pretty easily. It's acrylic based, so we can just spread it. Really work it into all the little lines. Using just a little spatula here. Grout texture is now applied in there, and I've taken the spatula and worked most of it out. Now I'm just taking a wide paintbrush dipped in a little water, and we're just going to lightly brush over this. And because the product is made out of acrylic, you can rehydrate it there. And then just taking a rag, You want to wipe over all of this. And the block comes back out. And we now have mortar in between each one of the pieces there. Here is the garden wall put into place over there. You can see how you can still see all of the bricks very well, but the grout is all filled in there. Now I'm using the same Ammolmate by MIG concrete product again, and this time we're doing it over all of the cobblestones, and we're doing light coats of it here. But you'll notice here how it's starting to fill in all of the little cracks and stuff that would eventually over time get filled with dirt in real life. And if you've ever laid tile before, I'm using the exact same principles. We lay the tile on there, we spread the grout all over the top, and using a wet rag, just going over it. You wipe off all of the excess off the top of the tiles, or in this case, cobblestones, and meanwhile, all of the center areas get filled in with sand, or in real life, sand or dirt, whatever it is on it right there. Gonna rotate the diorama around to the other side here. So on this side, I've created a little curbing in there. And instead of a sidewalk, on this side of the street, we're gonna have just like a little dirt berm that has like a grassy little area on it. I've seen quite a few pictures in Europe where that has that, where it could be a sidewalk on one side and then just a grassy area on the other. So I've gone ahead and done that. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill in the rest of the cobblestone gaps. Here's a close-up of the cobblestone with the product almost dry on it now. And remember, this is unpainted. It still needs to be painted and weathered, but it is really starting to pop right here. You can see all of the individual stones, all of the texturing. Really worthwhile spending all the time to cut. Now I'm creating the garden wall door, and I'm using some basswood, but before we start gluing it up, we're gonna take a wire brush like this and really rough up all of the boards here first. And that way we'll give the impression of a door that is a little bit older than brand new wood. And then once we get that done, I'll go ahead and build up some braces, cut those to length, put one on the bottom, put a door handle on, and then we'll create a hinge system for it to be able to attach to the inside of the door frame. Time to paint the cobblestones. I'm using my airbrush and using just flat black. I'm going to go over all of the cobblestones and spray them with black, making sure to get it all inside the little cracks. Create a shadow effect when we put our lighter grays on. Now, with this technique, we're going to start from dark and work gradually lighter and lighter as we apply paint. So right now, I am taking a medium gray and from a very low angle, spraying it across so it, as to not get too much of the gray paint into the areas that you want to create that shadow effect on. Once that is on, I am taking a foam brush and with the next lighter coat of paint, just blotting in a random pattern. And because the cobblestones are all uneven, each one of them is going to get patterned just a little bit different. And I'll use probably three different color grays on this, gradually, like I said earlier, from darker to lighter. And we'll just keep working them into each other and gradually trying to get a gray surface, but one that doesn't look too uniform. And if you do this while the paint is still wet, a lot of it will have a tendency to blend together. The last thing I'm doing is taking a very light coat and a very flat brush and hitting the cobblestones from different straight angles like this. And this has a tendency to give a little bit of a blending, so all of those little dots that we made with the foam sponge don't stick out as much. And it'll also catch all of the edges of the cobblestones and give them a lighter effect as if that area has been worn a little bit more. And here it is. Here is what the final product looked like. Now painting up the brick wall. I've sprayed the wall here with a mixture of buff over the entire thing, and then taking a little bit of a red-brown color, lightly misted on just certain bricks you know, just every other brick to give it a little variation in color. Now we're just gonna use some bone color with a foam sponge. And kind of showing to you, I'm just blotting it out on paper right here. And then we're just gonna start adding in some variation in color. And to start off with, it'll be quite stark of a contrast, but it will fade out and start to blend in with the other paints. And you want to keep changing the direction of your foams. That way you don't get any patterns build up. Okay, now that that paint has dried, we're going to be using some different ammo streaking effects. So in this case, we're going to start off with streaking grime. We're going to use a little rust. And for the bottom, we're going to use slimy dark green. And that is going to replicate the areas that will look like there's like some, you know, green algae growing or moss, whatever you want to call it at the bottom there, that stains the bottom. And we're also going to use a little bit of gray, just a tiny bit of that. But we'll start off by putting it on with a brush and blotting it on. And then immediately taking a sponge and blending it in, because we don't want any areas to be too dark with it. And using those multiple different colors, you will come up with something that looks like this. And I'll put it like that. You can see the green moss on the bottom and then the different variations of a natural stone product that looks like it's just been cut. So I'm going to finish up the rest of the wall, and then I will be able to go ahead and install it inside the rest of the diorama. And there is the garden wall all painted up and dry now. I've attached it in place using hot glue. Hot glue works really well when you're working with foam because it sets up very quickly. Sets up like super glue, but super glue can actually eat through this foam, so you don't really want to use super glue on any of the foam. White glue will work as well too, but white glue has a tendency to take a very long time to dry. This way I wanted it to make sure that it was butt right up against the sidewalk in a nice firm way, and I didn't want to risk using white glue, so a little bit of white glue underneath and then hot glue all around the back. Now you've also watched me work on the door, and I've finished up the door. What I did is I've created a couple of simple hinges just using some strip styrene and some bolts that I had that we just put on top there to make it look like it's attached to the door. And to get that wood effect there, all I did was spray the entire thing with buff and then a couple of coats of brown and gray panel liner from Tamiya. And we get a nice dirty effect on our door here. And this is going to get placed right in just like this. We'll mount it in there in a couple of minutes. Oh, actually, it's gonna stay there for a minute. So that is how that's gonna look. Also, you'll notice too that I've carried some of that slimy green down onto the pavement. That way it looks like it blends in together and like it always belonged there. And now that I have the wall in place, I've created a couple of big climbing bushes with flowers on it that I'm going to show you right now that I plan to drop into place right here. Kind of like covering over part of the wall and part of the hinges here. Two overgrown bushes that have completely flowered and are taking over part of the backyard. I've seen quite a few of these these big plants on the walls on the pictures that I've seen of Europe, so I thought I'd create a couple of those. Now, it's using the same type of material that I'm going to create the big tree. So, unfortunately, I didn't show you how this goes together, but I will show you the tree, and just know that it's the exact same process. The only difference is I sprinkled some red and pink flowers on the two different bushes. So I'll go ahead and hot glue that into place right now. So now we're taking a look at the product that I make the trees out of, as well as the big vine bushes type thing that are creeping over the top of the walls. And that is using the product called Super Trees from Scenic Express. And when you open up inside here, now obviously I've been using this quite a bit, but you get this, it's basically like a natural product from the, I believe it's out of the ocean. And when it dries, it looks very, very similar to trees. You can soak this in water, hot water, and straighten them out if you have any ones that are bent already, because they are dried kind of angled. But this is what I use right here. I take this, we'll paint it, then spray the entire thing with a spray adhesive, and then basically just use their super leaf. I buy the big bags because I make quite a few trees over the years, and you just basically sprinkle this on while the spray adhesive is still wet, and you have a tree when it's all done. And it's the same thing for the bushes. So for the bush part, we'll just basically rip off the, you know, the twig in the middle, and you will have, and then of course sprinkle it with the imitation flowers from Woodland Scenics after it's done. Now, I have a few other complete videos on YouTube that will show a more in-depth. If you're interested in that, it'll show you how the trees actually go together. But they're pretty easy to put together. They're quick, and they look really, really nice once they're done. So now I'm going to show you the tree I just created. And here is the tree all done up. And what I did was, when you watch me put the bush together, I did the exact same thing. The only difference is I took a piece of twig basically from the yard, and then just started super gluing on all of the other little branches to build up this big tree here. And now the tree is just in place, just kind of leaning up against the wall. It's not permanent yet. I've been kind of rotating it around to see what the best position is. I kind of like this though, that the branch is hanging way over the sidewalk. I think it'll look really, really cool on that, and it's going to give a lot of character and a little height to the actual diorama. Now here's my hand in here to give you an idea of scale. Next thing I need to do is I need to put the dirt work in the back in that little courtyard area. And I'm also going to fill in the dirt area on the corner here, remembering that the curb is proper and is painted in there. All I need to do now is put some dirt and grass. I'm going to use Ammo by Migs acrylic mud. I'm going to fill in all this area here, put a thin little layer on. That'll be our dirt level, or layer, excuse me, underneath. And then I'm also going to do that in the back by the tree. That'll help secure all of that into place. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. The mud is drying now on all the different surfaces, and I am taking some of RT Diorama's leaf litter and I'm applying it into some of the little areas in front of the curbs, up against the wall, and of course on the back curb over here. And I will spray it down with a little rubbing alcohol to break the surface tension, and then using a little mixture of white glue and water, we'll be able to attach all of that down. But I like the way that's adding some nice little bit of debris from the plants and stuff along, and also the pink flowers still, because in Arizona, when anytime these flowers bloom, they're blowing everywhere and they're always accumulating it all in the corners of walls and things. So I'm going to go ahead and attach that down right now. And here we go, guys. Here is our completed diorama base. I've let the glue dry on all the grass. The grass looks great up in the front there, especially with all the little leaf debris and weeds. We've got all that same debris up against the back wall here. And this diorama in 16 scale is ready to display some of our 16 scale vehicles. I have to say, it was a lot of work cutting all those bricks, but I definitely think it was worth it and would definitely do it again. It really adds so much character to the diorama, having all the uneven bricks, and just makes it really pop, especially in person. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to take a 16 scale vehicle that I've built up. This is the Panzer 1B from TACOM. And just like that, we have a May of 1940 diorama ready to go. And I love the way that looks right there. Now this, I've patterned this to be the front of the diorama, but actually you could rotate this 90 degrees and from this direction could be the front, especially if you're going to do like a tank around the corner that's ambushing, something like that. So we're going to pull this one right now. And hopefully the track line up here. Do it like that. Take our Das Werk 1/16 scale Stug, and now we have a May of 43 diorama all ready to go. Just need to put some figures and things on it, and this is going to come in real handy, especially any 16 scale vehicles that are out. We could build all kinds of other things for it, but wanted to show you the ins and outs and how this goes together. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please go ahead and hit the like button. And if you haven't done so already, you can go ahead and subscribe by hitting the button down in the corner and ring the bell, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. So I want to take this opportunity to thank you as always for watching, and please stay tuned because I have many more videos coming.